pedido el reposo y abastado de mortal pena, con coja y braveza.
Mary Carey, Your Majesty.
Who?
Your new lady-in-waiting and her sister, Anne.
Well, then she must be some kind of gift.
Sing for us.
Really, I beg you.
Sing.
Western wind, when will thou blow the small rain down? Can rain, Christ, if my love were in my arms and I in my bed again.
Mary, stop. That can't have been easy for you. But put yourself in the Queen's shoes. She knows the only reason the King has asked you here is because he desires you. She's a good woman, trust me. Jane Parker.
She has her eye on you. Sweet Jane Parker would be a match to please our father.
Oh, vile girl. She's the most ambitious little serpent at court.
She can't stop watching.
To become an earl, your brother a viscount. In addition, we have received a number of new grants and estates, so our debts are paid, and there's more. George, the king will arrange a match between you and Jane Parker.
I beg you, Father. No.
I thought you had ambitions for this family. The girl's well-connected, her father's cousin to the king.
Must I actually marry her?
Of course you must marry her. Have you no pride? Or would you rather leave everything to Mary?
No, sir.
The baby lives. She is not miscarried. But for the sake of the child, she must begin her lying-in immediately.
And so you must return as your uncle bids. You are to entertain the king and keep his mind on Mary at all times. That is your task and no more.
Welcome back at court.
My lord.
What? I suppose he felt that she'd been banished long enough.
But in whose interest do they imagine she'll act? Certainly not mine.
Why do they make this room such a dungeon? Does it have to be this dark?
Where were you?
Just visiting Mary.
As ever.
Well, now that Anne's back, you can be doubly jealous.
I'm your wife. You never lie with me.
Dad. Anem et infirmam sicut sponsus debet sponsum. Ile soli ad aerere, quam dio vita utrisque vestrum duravet.
Almost without pain. And so quickly. As if it never was. Get rid of it! Bury it! Get rid of it somehow! On the fire with it! Tell the king in the morning. Let's pray he takes pity on me. I saw them. The two of them.
Yes. Fetch my belongings and bring them to Rochford.
Grace, Lady Rochford is here to see you.
Not now.
She has news of her husband, George Boleyn, and the Queen.
What is it?